It's going to be one of those fights where Canelo gets the credit that he deserves. A lot of people haven't really given him that credit. I don't know, because of the catch weights or whatever it is, the clauses that he puts in the contracts, but...
There's no rehydration.
I don't think so. He's doing the right thing. That way, every Mexican fan that has maybe been against him because of that, now we're gonna see. They're gonna see that he didn't want to do it, and he beat a solid light heavyweight.
Do you feel like he has to prove a point given his failed test? That he had, a lot of people are still discrediting what he has accomplished due to that. Do you feel that he's almost like having to reprove himself?
I don't think he thinks like that, because he cares less what people say. You know, I know that as a fighter, he wants obviously people to love and respect him, but whatever he hears out on the outside, he doesn't really care. He's got the best contract in sports. He's got everything he wants, but this win would definitely put him in that level where, why would somebody talk bad about him? Why would somebody say something bad when he just moved up two divisions to fight and beat somebody like the Crusher?
Now, before the year is out, we have two big heavyweight matchups. November 23rd, Wilder Ortiz. In my opinion, Wilder faced the most adversity, one fight in Luis Ortiz. And then December 7th, we got the rematch in AJ and Andy Ruiz. Break each of those fights down. Both of them are rematches.
Both are great fights. You know, Ortiz gave some trouble to Wilder the first time. Eventually, Wilder knocked him out. And I think this fight is going to be a fight where Ortiz probably learned a lot, and it's going to be maybe in better shape. It'll be interesting. I still think Wilder, the power he's got is just unbelievable. On the Reese Joshua fight, I think it's gonna be a little bit harder for Reese, but I still pick Reese by knockout. But I think it's gonna be a little bit more difficult. Even though I believe he already took Joshua's mentality, mental, beat him already, and his heart. I think he already dominated him there. I think he's still gonna be. I think he's gonna give him some trouble for a few rounds, but eventually he's gonna dominate.
What are your thoughts to the people that say that maybe the money and the fame have gotten a little bit to Andy Ruiz?
Because people seen him celebrate his birthday. That doesn't mean he's out there partying. He's already in Guadalajara training for his fight. No, the fight's not till December, and I know his trainer Manny. He trains his fighters very hard. You know, because you see a video of somebody partying, you know, because you're celebrating your birthday, that doesn't mean you're out there partying, you know, but that's what everybody wants to say and everybody wants to believe. I think he's going to be in better shape this time. I know he's got a great team behind him, and it always is going to do his job. Estrella House is going to do his part, and they're going to take Reese in the best shape of his life.
Robert Garcia, thank you very much.
Robert, what you make of the video of Kerry Russell running up?
Look, I don't think that was, I think that was a little disrespectful, you know, for him to do that. You know, the dad doesn't know the language, playing with his chains, and you know, I think it was a little disrespectful, but I know Gary Russell's not a bad person either. You know, the whole family, since the amateurs, I've known that family. They've always been very respectful. People love that family. I think it was more to make the fight happen. On the other side, Leo, Leo has a great heart. He has nothing bad to say about nobody. Leo just says, look, I don't take it personal. I'll let my people handle that. You know, if I fight them, I'll fight them. If they say I'm a fighter, you know, Leo's just the best, you know, has the best heart in boxing. He has never, will never say nothing bad about anybody. I think it was a little disrespectful to go up to the dad like that, but sometimes you got to do stuff like that to make the fight happen, you know. Sometimes fighters punch each other, say something bad about the wife. They just go back and forth because they want to make the fight happen. I think that's what Gary Russell tried. He just trying to make the fight. He wants the fight, and maybe he'll get it.
The dad thought it was Rico Ramos.
That's what I mean. See, the dad didn't even know, and the dad doesn't know the language, you know. I think he didn't have to act differently because he had no idea what was going on. You know, was it disrespectful? I do believe so. You know, go up to a, especially, you know, an older man, and, you know, he's fighting cancer. I think it was disrespectful, but it was just something to do to make the fight happen. You know, he wants that fight. I know the Russians, okay. And they're good people too.
What happens if they do fight?
Look, Santa Cruz, he'll fight. He throws a lot of punches. He'll fight anybody. He doesn't care. It's a tough fight for both of them. I don't want to say Gary Russell wins easily, or I don't want to say Leo wins easily, you know, because it's going to be a tough fight for both. I would love to see it, but I still got to support Leo. You know, he's Southern California, Mexican, from Michoacan, so we got to support our people.
Robert, one of your favorite fighters is Lomachenko.
Yes,
who do you want to see him fight next? Personally?
I would love to see him fight Mikey. And I would like Mikey. I would love Mikey to fight him. You know,
what happens in that fight?
It's a hell of a fight, man. It's a beautiful fight, man. Lomachenko. I know Lomachenko when he came to Oxnard. He trained in my gym for a while. He's, you know, his manager is friends with mine, you know, so I know him personally, and I know they'll fight anybody. They want those fights. They want those huge fights. So I just hope that fight happens in the future.